Let's take a look at our spring semester final review guide. And let's also use Geogebra to assist with some of these questions. You will be allowed to use your Chromebook on the final, so this could be a method to assist. Now, which graph matches the equation y equals negative 2x plus 3? So if I had no idea where to start, if I was totally lost, if I forgot what the slope-intercept form of an equation is and what it means, then I would use Geogebra to type in the equation y equals negative 2x plus 3 in the input bar, enter, and there you go. You've got the graph. That quick, that easy, no big deal. Now, sticking up that line here, I'm not going to slow down here in terms of showing you step by step what to do when using Geogebra, but there's the equation, and it looks like I may have moved this. So let me go backspace here really quick. Let's go backspace. There we go. So let's go here. Let's thicken that up. Yeah, all right. So if I take a good look at this equation, it looks like the graph itself, I'm going to go to the intersection point here, intersects at 3. There's the coordinate 0, 3. And then if I was to even go further and look at some of these numbers, where is it at? There it is, slope. If I click on the line, it gives me a slope of negative 2. See, it figures that out for me, which is slick, isn't it? Yeah. So a slope of negative 2, a y-intercept of 3. I could right-click on the point A, go to Object Properties, and see where it says Show Label. You can actually choose just the value. So there it is. It shows you the value of that point, which is 0, 3. And that is the y-intercept. So which graph is that? Well, looks like letter D, or B, sorry, B. It's in right here, B. And if you take a good look at that, you can see it. It's 3. Down 2 over 1, that's the one right there. Hope you can see that. Now moving on, I've got another question that maybe we can use Geogebra for. I think number 4 is a good one. It says, which inequality is best represented by the following number line? So my number line shows a number line going from negative 2 to the right, which means all of these values are greater than negative 2. The point is open, it just means that negative 2 is not part of the solution. So A, B, C, and D are inequalities. Which of those inequalities is the graph given on that number line? So will Geogebra do this? I think it can. Let's try it. So let's go down to the input bar. Start with A. You have to go through all 4 to see which one's the correct graph. So we'll start with A, 2x plus 20 is greater than 16. Enter. That does not look like a number line. So what happened? Well, if you right-click on the inequality and go to Object Properties, where it says Style, that third option, there's a check mark that says Show on Axis, and that just changes the style of your graph there. It's not a shaded region, it's actually a number line, right? And so there you have it, and you can see, and I don't want to see that letter A there, I don't want to show that label. But there it is, it's -2, -1, 0, so we got lucky. Letter A is the answer. That graph matches the graph that you see on number 4. So the answer is A. If you chose B as an answer and you were to switch this inequality around, you could just double click on there and switch that. That is going in the wrong direction. You see that? And then if you were to choose letter D, it's the same situation. You just put an equal sign after the inequality. Oops, let's go equal and then 16. That's going to be the less than or equal to. And see that? Ooh, that was way off. What happened there? It said 16. There you go. So you can see that's a solid point. We don't want solid, we want open, right? So no underline. No underline there. And of course, if I whipped it around the other way, again, almost right, except that point is solid. We want it open, which leads us back to this original inequality, letter A. Number 5. Let's try number 5. So let's delete this. Let's go use Geogebra again. Input. Let's graph that equation. Hey, sounds like the best thing to do, right, is to just graph it and see what's going on. Once I graph it, I'll read the directions again. Thicken up the line a bit. Mm-hmm. Looks good. And now the directions say, what is the y-intercept of the line with the equation 7x plus 5, y equals negative 35? Y-intercept, well, The y-axis is vertical. Where does the graph, the line, cross the y-axis? Well, it looks like it crosses at negative 7. Now again, 0, negative 7. Do you see that? That is the coordinate of point A. Again, I can right-click if I wanted to. I can go to the basics where it says name. Why not go name and value where it says, gives the name of the point A, and then it tells you the coordinate. But negative 7 is the value of that y-coordinate, and so the answer is going to be A here for number 5. Wow, that's so easy. You're telling me that most of this work can be done very quickly with this device called Geogebra? Yeah, that's what I'm telling you. We've talked about it all year long, so let's delete that. Let's go to the next question. Solve by substitution. What do I do here? Well, solve by substitution, it says 3x plus 2y equals negative 4 and y equals 4x minus 2. Why don't we graph it? See what happens. So let's do it. 3x plus 2y equals negative 4. Enter. And the other one is y equals 4x minus 2. So there you have it. Now, what I notice about these two graphs is that they intersect. Wonder where that point's at. What's the coordinate of that point? So go to my intersection tool, click there. It's called point A. I want to see that on my graph, object properties, show name and value. And there you have it. So now I see that that point is 0, negative 2. Now you'll notice that maybe I don't know what that means, but if I look at the possible answers, A, B, C, and D, I see that A has a coordinate of 0, negative 2, which means that when you have a system of equations, that just means you have two or more equations, and they ask you to solve them, you are looking for the intersection point of the two graphs. These lines will intersect. That's called the solution to a system of equations. So where do they intersect? They intersect at coordinates x equals 0 and y equals negative 2. And so that's the solution. You may also see it written as x equals 0 and y equals negative 2 as a solution. And if let's see, I'll write that down here with my pen. Not going to be too pretty. That's okay. It'll be x equals 0 and y equals negative 2. Let me do one more and then we'll stop, upload it to the channel. Number 7. Let's delete that there. Delete. Number 7. Which of the following ordered pairs is a solution to the inequality y is greater than 2x minus 6? Y is greater than 2x minus 6. Enter. Now look at that. Thicken that line up. Well, it's kind of weird. I didn't see it thicken up. Object properties. Let's see. There you go. Now it's sticking it up. I'm gonna change the color. I'm gonna go with the green. Much better. So now I'm looking at that, and the line is dashed. Number one, it's shaded, and then it says, which of the following ordered pair is a solution to the inequality? So this ordered pair, ordered pairs are. It's a point. So let's go to a point here, right? Let's click on the graph. And there's a point, and I want to see the coordinate of that point. So I'm going to go to object properties, and let's go to basic, let's go name and value. So a solution to this inequality means that the point has to be in the shaded region. That's what it means. So let's go to -1, 4. -1, 4, that's up here. Hey, that's a solution because it's in the shaded region. You see that? Is 1, negative 5 there? 1, negative 5? Nope. That's on the other side. See it? It's not a solution. Look at C. 3, 0. Hey, 3, 0 is on. It's on the line that's dashed. The line is dashed. And you're on it. You're not a solution. And then 0, 0. Wow. 0, 0 is a solution. So what I did here was, looks like I chose two possible answers, A and D. On the final, there won't be two answers. It's just one. So in this case, it looks like A and D would be the solution. But anyway, hope that helps. Like I always say, study hard, learn a lot. We will see you soon. Bye-bye.